the Vikings now to start their next drive. Just the one misstep for them in the first half of the season. 7-1 is the record at the midway point. And in terms of whatever power rankings you want to go by, they're at or near the top of the list in terms of best teams in the National Football League.
And for me and my little bit of rankings here, I've got them at the top. I know there's still 2 months to go. We've seen teams get off to hot starts and then fade away due to injuries or the schedule or whatever. But unless there are a rash of injuries on this team, I'd be surprised if they aren't a first or a second seed come playoff time.
2nd and 10. Here's Tua. Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. Anthony Barr comes rumbling in for the sack.
Well, competition comes up in so many different ways. And right now, this unit, their competition is who's going to get to the quarterback the most times. How about 5 sacks last week? We just saw the first one of this game.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. They'll roll him out right. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Running left, it's Fournette. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
2nd down, back to Fournette. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 55 rushing yards rushing for him now, and he's only carried the ball 4 times. 2 first downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. Throw right side, caught by O.J. Howard. Touchdown, Vikings! Well, for a tight end, he can definitely motor, and he shows off the wheels there after the catch as he's able to shake free.
Yeah, normally when you talk about tight ends, you immediately begin talking about them rumbling down the field, but to me, he was pretty well gliding downfield there. Very athletic for a big man, and he takes this one all the way to pay dirt.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Charger drive about to get going. A 6-2 is their record through the first 8 weeks. Now, Charles, what is your assessment for them in the second half of the season?
Well, I think that the road gets a little bit tougher for them. And when I look at their schedule, I see some of these road games, and I know those are going to be difficult. But this is a good team, so I'm going to go with 11-5. That seems about right, and I think that'd be a nice accomplishment, too.
To throw once more on 2nd and 10. Murray. Well, I'm not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They forced incompletions on 1st and 2nd down, bring up 3rd and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
You better be ready. I'll be scared of it. Watch 18. 18's the mic. Let's go deep. Tighten up. Let's go deep.
Here's Murray. Got an open man here, and it's K.J. Hamler. And he is going to have the Chargers' first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. They fake the handoff. Now Murray. Escaping the pressure right. Going deep for Hopkins. And this one is incomplete.
A deep ball down that right sideline, and he made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Play fake. Murray. Going deep for Hopkins. And that is going to be caught in one-handed. Wow. A big play there for L.A.
He can really smell 800 catches right now because that last one puts him at 799, knocking on the door. Throwing again, Murray. And incomplete on the deep ball.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over it, and they got there to break that one up.
On second and 10, Murray going for it all. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range. So now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10.
Watch 18. 18's the mic.
Now Murray. Yeah, this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now since it's fourth down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to three. Tucker's kick is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, and I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. Complete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here. Third and 10. Now Tua. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there. And now fourth down. On fourth down, here's Andy Leon to kick it away. Back deep to return is KJ Hamler. Yards on the punt, give him just 1 yard on the return, and it'll be Charger football here as they take over. The Charger drive about to get going. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left. We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs. So they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them.
You get me? He's not going to get me? Number 16's coming. Check mine. Check mine.
Hey, watch. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and four. Now this time, Murray to throw it. On the move to his left. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a third down.
And while he did a good job of sliding around in the pocket, there was nowhere to go with the football, so he had to take off and try and run. He just got back to the line of scrimmage. No gain.
Murray going to throw. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
Here's second and 10. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. A throw left side, hold in by Hamler. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of four.
Brings up third and six.
From the gun on third down, Murray. And going for Hamler, but this is intercepted. It's Chris Harris with a pick. And the Vikings are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it's a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well, protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
And they get to him after a gain of six to the 46. So, Charles, this defense, you know, they definitely know that they've got their hands full here going up against a group that has won seven straight. What's the key for them in this ball game?
Well, we asked their defensive coordinator that very question, and the response was, we have the mindset that they actually have to react to us, not the other way around. So it sounds to me like the plan is to do the attacking and not wait to see what they present to them.
Tua looking to throw on third and two. And he's got a man. It's the tight end Howard complete. And he will have a Vikings first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7-yard gain there on third and two. Play action. Now it's Tua. And he just throws this one away. That was a bit strange. And here comes the flag. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field. Have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. Tua sets up to pass it. This one complete to Scott Miller. They get 14 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. Off of play action, Tagovailoa. That'll be caught. It's the tight end Howard. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. To a hit, and the ball is out. And this is recovered by the Chargers. Every week we hear talk about create turnovers. In particular, they wanted to force some fumbles. They got one right there.
And it shows you how the game has changed over time. It used to be good enough for a guy to get a sack of a quarterback in the pocket. Now, if you come to the sidelines and you didn't knock the ball free, your coaches are upset with you, all right? So if you're a quarterback, it starts all the way back in the youth leagues. Take care of the ball, take care of the ball, take care of the ball, because here come the defenders.
The Charger drive about to get going as they go to work with 12 seconds on the clock. He'll go up top here for Hamler. And that's caught inside the 35. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A big gain that time for the Chargers. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Murray now to throw. That's caught right side by Anderson. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. A gain of 6 there on first. And that extra yardage makes this upcoming field goal attempt much more manageable.
Agreed, because when you talk to defensive coordinators, they always tell us the 35-yard line on our side of the field, that's the line we guard the most aggressively, because once they get there, they believe they're in field goal range.
And Tucker's kick right there. It's good, and that will do it for this first half. So we hit halftime with our visitors, the Vikings, taking the lead to the locker room as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Chargers going to get the football first here in the second half, and they trail as we get back underway. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. The Charger drive about to get going. And they do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
Defensively, Jimmy Ward in on the stop. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Throwing now is Murray. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll be out right at the 35.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Murray now. Flush to his right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. To throw, it's Murray. And he finds Gronk. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1. He's up to the 48.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. On first down, they'll run with Nwangu. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
The more football I watch, the more I want to check and see if teams are going to panic when they're down on the scoreboard. And this team has shown no signs of doing that. A lot of the time, they come out after the half. Things haven't worked so well in the first go-around. They won't throw the football like crazy. But the way to open up throwing the ball is to run it. And they've run it well here to start the second half.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves them with 2 to go on second down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Eight yards the tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. Here's a handoff out of the gun. Gets around him. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line.
Giving up respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
From the red zone, here's the Heisman Trophy winner, Murray. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown. His 16th touchdown of the year. And the Chargers are going to retake the lead. Staley telling his troops to stay out there and go for 2. It appears they're going to throw for it with Murray. Flushed out right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of 2-point tries and see what the data tells us. Because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the 3 to the 2, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive. Here's 2nd and 9. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. Throw right side caught by O.J. Howard. And they've got it well across midfield down to the 40 before it's all said and done. A big connection on that one. 34 yards.
First down Vikings.
So the big play moves them all the way across midfield to the 40 now for 1st and 10. Looking to pass. Tua. Buying time to his left. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. Setting to throw on first down is Tua. This will be caught. It's Waddle. Touchdown! Jalen Waddle, his 25th touchdown. Tying Emmitt Smith for the fifth most in one season. And the Vikings have once again taken the lead. Tua going to try and throw for it. And that is caught for the 2 points. So they make the decision. They want a 3-point lead versus a 2-point lead, and they got it.
Yeah, at this stage of the game, it seems like the exact right thing to do. Put a little pressure on your defense, but the biggest thing now is you're making the other team chase you.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Charger drive about to get going, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
What a difference a week makes. Last week he hit on over 80% of his passes. This week he's down under 50%. What do you see as the difference?
Well, I think we're used to seeing a drop. If someone's over 80%, they're not going to hold that number, not in this league. But a drop under 50%, that just tells me that the defense has spent a lot of extra time on game films and came up with a really good plan to try and chip away at his timing.
Throwing again on second and 10. Murray. And he comes back with one complete. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
First and 10, here's Murray. Throwing left side, he's got Gronk, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
13 more yards.
Three quarters in the books. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 46. Now Murray again. And he'll air this one deep for Anderson. And that is caught at the 10-yard line. A big game that time for the Chargers.
Well, this is where an offense needs to show what it's made of. And in fact, where a quarterback needs to show what he's made of. Trying to engineer a fourth quarter comeback. And he hits a big one right there.
And only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Here's second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line. And he's going to ball his way down to about the 1-yard line. The keeper gets him 7 that time, but it'll lead to a 3rd down.
Some good strong running right there. Some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play. 3rd and goal. Now this time, Murray to throw it. Sliding out of the pocket. And this will be caught in the end zone. The Chargers touchdown. Kenny Mwangi, his 3rd touchdown now. Chargers have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. And now remember, all touchdowns are reviewed, and in a tight game like this, they're going to take a good long look at it.
Tucker with the extra point. That will make this a four-point game. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
Tyler Lancaster there to make the play defensively.
Not a lot of running room there. Not a place to make a cut and kind of exit out because they had everything bottled up. Looked to me like the linemen were taking on their blocks really well and giving up no creases.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. They'll run it again with Fournette. Fighting through. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 72 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're kind of up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. From the gun, it's Tua. Got a man complete to Miller. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 30. Fournette, a first down carry. Oh, no, he lost the football.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. On second and seven. Tua, and that'll be caught by Tony. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 14. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. They'll try the right side here with Fournette. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Possession inside the five.
Second time he's fumbled in this game. Fortunate for him, this one goes out of bounds.
And the key for him now is, how much equity have you built up with your coaching staff? How much equity have you built up with your team to continue to get opportunities? Fortunate that one went out of bounds, saved him from a turnover.
Down four late, got to go for it here on fourth down. Go with a big back for that. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the five at the four. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. If you're going to run against this unit, especially down here, just beware. I mean, they're the top rushing defense in the league.
Yeah, and then they go ahead and they double down with the whole thing because you think, okay, let's throw the ball. Oh, yeah, that's right. They defend the pass pretty well, too. Very difficult task right now.
And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. A lot of tired bodies on that field. But this is a big play, third and goal. They'll try to punch it in with Fournette. They push forward, but I don't think it's enough. He's going to be about a yard short. He needed three, he got two. Now that will set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard. And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. Final try for Tagovailoa. And this is going to be caught. It's caught. And they've won the football game.
So for those of little faith, guess what? It got done. They now have the lead with that touchdown this late in the contest. I wonder if that was a play they were holding or a play that they just knew would work from past experience.
Well, I just saw it in their eyes on the sideline before starting that last drive, and they did. You're right. They got it done. Looks like they're going to be the winners. So the final seconds have ticked away in this Minnesota victory, and this coaching staff, CD, I think you'd agree, pleased with this overall effort.
I think they're more than pleased, right? They've got to look at each other like, wow, we just pulled this one off in a big way. Great job of motivating. Even better job of game planning. They were facing a top 10 defense, so they had to make sure that everything was buttoned down and they had it ready to go, and their guys executed.
Look, I played the game, I missed the shot, I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance for not, my not, my not, for flexing. I fell out and cut the check, my not, paralyzed the set, but I been taking hits like I can't die like innocent. Morning the day, the dawn of the dead day, I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it, the nigga, the serpent, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping and run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances, I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand, the colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my guts, the world is us, so what? Who wanna touch, who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust, kicking the dough when I come at the cut. Well, yeah. Who wanna touch, who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust, do what I do and I say what I want. Well, yeah, mommy, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack on my jacket at Grammy. You see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city. You see the duality. Who trying to battle me, huh? Hitters is after me. Can I be dabbing you? Who wanna fuck me up? Fatality really is up. It's sure, undoubtedly. Baby, gon' touch the bucks. My salary double. Your baby daddy maybe triple. I'm trouble. I get the tackle in the pick and I hustle. I had to have it. Had to get in the huddle. In the gravel and rubble. Got me a sack and I'm trying to be subtle. We just hacking like a dog with a muzzle. See the bagger, put him back in the puddle. We attacking, better stand back and watch him run. Shotgun, come.